ETF, ETN, ETC, ETP, what are these instruments? Check it out. Hi everyone, my name is Francesco Fantechi and today I want to be talking about the difference between an ETF, an ETN, an ETC and an ETP. So let's start talking about ETFs. So ETFs stand for Exchange Traded Fund, and these funds are basically funds that differently from mutual funds are managed in a passive way, which means that the manager of the fund does not manage the fund actively, meaning that it does not change securities very often within the fund, but he keeps them constant, he keeps them quite the same over time, unless there is a change in the benchmark. Generally, the ETF can represent funds of stocks, funds of bonds, funds of other securities and instruments. For example, cover call ETFs have a series of stocks or an index, and then some cover calls are sold against this index, this fund. Generally speaking, they have lower commissions than mutual funds because these funds are not managed in an active way, but they are managed in a passive way. Generally speaking, we can say that exchange-traded funds are very popular among investors, and in fact they are becoming more and more popular as more investors get into this kind of funds and buy them, in contrast to mutual funds that generally tend to underperform. Even if they have an active management style, they tend to underperform the benchmark. Generally speaking, exchange traded funds can replicate a benchmark such as the S&P 500, the Nasdaq and so on, or they can simply represent a strategy made out of different securities that are chosen and left the same within the fund. The second category of products that we want to be talking about today are the exchange traded notes. Exchange traded notes are debt securities that are generally held by banks, and they generally represent an obligation to pay shareholders based on some categories of assets. So they do not have the asset themselves, but they have some derivatives that tend to replicate the basically returns and drawdowns of the asset itself. The most important products in that regard are the so-called ETC. The ETC are exchange traded commodities. Exchange traded commodities meaning that these are debt securities, debt titles within the index, but the only difference is that they represent only commodities instead of other kinds of assets such as stocks or bonds. So generally speaking, when we talk about stocks and bonds, we talk about ETFs, and when we talk about commodities, we talk about ETC and ETN, exchange traded notes, and consequently exchange traded commodities. The last kind of product that we want to be talking about are the exchange traded products. Exchange traded products are all these three products together. So all these three kind of assets that we talked about are grouped and can be enlisted as exchange traded products. So generally speaking, we can say that exchange traded products are the head of these different products, and then we can subdivide them into exchange traded funds, exchange traded notes, which are debt titles held by banks, and exchange traded commodities, which themselves belong to exchange trading notes, and in particular are debt title within the commodity and future space. In fact, generally ETC are represented and are derived from futures contracts of commodities, of whatever commodities we want to take into consideration when building our exchange traded traded commodities. I guess that that was all for today. I thank you all for the attention. If you like the video, please smash the thumbs up and comment down below. Also, if you like this kind of video about trading, investing, money online, business online, jobs and so on, please subscribe down here. I'm going to come tomorrow with a new video about this topic, so please check it out, and remember to subscribe to the channel and put the like. Thank you so much again for the attention. Have a great rest of your week.